So unfortunately, you hurt your back. So let's go over like a 5-step process to get yourself feeling better, all the things you should do. Now, I also want to say this is not a video for, say, a power lifter who just deadlifted 405 pounds and like really hurt their back. This is for the average person like myself, middle age, in your 50s, who maybe drop their keys on the floor, they bend down and they just feel their back kind of pull. Then you kind of feel stiff and you're in pain. So let's go through all the steps you should take to get yourself feeling better and to hopefully prevent this from ever happening again. And then we're also gonna cover towards the end of the video what happens, unfortunately, if you wind up with chronic back pain, like you've had back pain for over 6 months, what I think you should do to get rid of it. Now, the first thing you wanna do right after hurting your back is to first assess how bad is it. If it's excruciating and you got pain running down your leg and your leg is saying numb, immediately call your doctor. But if it's more of like, you know, you're uncomfortable, you feel stiff, you feel tight, but you're able to get out of bed and move around, I think it's okay to try to fix it on your own. And the first thing I would do is I would start walking. Do like short walks. If you can walk 5 to 10 minutes pain-free, try to do that 2 to 3 times per day. Walking is one of the singular best things you can do for your back to strengthen it and just to get the blood circulating. Plus, it could just make you feel a lot better. But don't overdo it. Don't go for like an hour long walk that can aggravate your back. Whatever your back can tolerate, 5 to 10 minutes, 2 to 3 times a day. And you might be thinking about taking anti-inflammatory, like an Aleve or something. And there are pros and cons to that, okay? The con is that the inflammation of a new injury, to see those liquids actually do help heal the body. So some research has shown that if you take anti-inflammatory medication, you actually slow down the healing process. But this is what I say. I think it's okay to take some, say, Aleve, but more as a painkiller as opposed to an anti-inflammatory short term. Let me explain what I mean by that. See, when you have a new injury, your brain, your central nervous system really like wakes up and says, whoa, I'm in pain. When I bend over like that, my back hurts. So your central nervous system will not forget that. And it's gonna really minimize motion. Even when your back is healed, you may still feel pain because your central nervous system was not taught that it's okay to move in those positions again. So by taking, say, an Aleve, maybe just for 2 or 3 days, just to reduce the pain, it'll keep you moving pain-free and it won't program that pain signal into your brain. So that's what I might recommend too. Obviously, I'm not a doctor, so check with your doctor before taking any type of medication, even over the counter, like an Aleve. But it might be a good idea to walk, say, 10 minutes 3 times a day and then take a Aleve, just a mild dose, maybe 1 in the morning, 1 at night with food, just to keep the pain a little bit lower. Let's move on to phase two. Let's say you've been walking 10 minutes, 2-3 times a day for a couple of weeks. Hopefully you're feeling a little bit better. Now it's time to start strengthening your back. And what I would recommend are these exercises called the Big Three. There's a famous professor out of Canada. He's called Stuart McGill. He wrote like textbooks on lower back pain. Really famous guy. Read all his books. Love all his work. He has 3 exercises that he feels are the best and safest way to strengthen your back. One exercise is called the plank. The other one is called the bird dog. And the third one is like a partial sit-up. And I'm going to link below this video in the description section a link where you can go look at those 3 exercises. I really highly recommend you doing them. Great way. If you have a biomechanical issue, if you have muscular imbalances, these 3 exercises are probably the best and safest way to strengthen your back. Now in phase 3, let's assume you've been walking 10 minutes, right? You're doing your big 3 exercises. Now you wanna start moving. You wanna remap your central nervous system to get rid of this pain for good. And this is what I mean. Remember when I talked about the Aleve earlier in the video? Your brain is not gonna forget positions that cause you pain. And even though the injury might be healed, you might still feel the pain. I know it sounds a little crazy. So what you have to do is you have to move easily in all different planes of motion to prove to your central nervous system that you're not injured anymore. Plus, mobility movement, just easy movement, is just great to lubricate the joints, to circulate blood and oxygen. Incredible thing to do. So I want you to do something called active stretching, where you're just actively moving. You see when I'm moving my shoulders, obviously this is something you would not necessarily do for your back. This is what I mean by mobility movement. And I'm gonna give you another link below this video, a guy that I think is incredible, Dr. Eric Cobb. He created this whole system called 𝙒𝘼𝙏𝘾𝙃. And I'm gonna link up a few of his lower back videos of mobility movement that I'd like you to start doing. Okay, so you're doing your walks, you're doing your strengthening. Now you're gonna start doing mobility movement. Now, hopefully you won't even need phase four. You know, you're 5-6 weeks after an injury and you're feeling better. But if you're not feeling better and you've done everything we talked about, you've been walking, you've been trying to strengthen your back, you've been doing mobility movement, and your back is still hurting you and you're 5-6 weeks into it, now it's definitely time to get some professional advice. I would go to your general practitioner. Don't run to a surgeon yet. First, go to your normal family doctor that knows you. They may want to do some imaging. You know, I say an x-ray is probably a good thing to do. You just want to, at this point, you want to rule out any serious health conditions. Say, God forbid you have a tumor in your back. I'm sure you don't. It would be highly unlikely for that to be the case, but it's nice to get some imaging. There are pros and cons of getting, say, an MRI or a CAT scan. You know, the pros is that it's going to show a lot, but that's also a con, also a negative. Like, for example, anyone over the age of 40, you're going to see something most likely on an MRI. You may see a herniated disc, a bulged disc. You may see a little bit of stenosis. You may see some arthritis. And if that's going to freak you out and make you really upset, you might not want to get the MRI. You may just want to stick with an x-ray. For example, if a surgeon points to like a herniation set and said, oh my God, I've never seen a herniation that big. You really need an operation. An operation should be your last resort. You know, don't run and get an operation. If you looked at my MRI of my lumbar, like lower back, every single disc is herniated or bulged. I got moderate stenosis. I got arthritis yet. I'm very functional. My back's doing great. So what I would recommend is you go to your general doctor and do an x-ray to rule out anything bad, and then get a prescription to go see a physical therapist. And a physical therapist should expand upon those big three exercises. They can probably still want you to do them, but they'll give you a much more complete rehab program. They may do some modalities like a little stim, muscle stim, things along the lines of that. So that should be your step in phase four. Work with a physical therapist. Now in phase five, this is when things get a little complicated. Unfortunately, let's say you're not better. You've done it all. You worked with the physical therapist. It's like 6 months. Your back is still bothering you. You're in like a chronic back pain situation. Okay. This is when I want you to take more of a psychological approach to getting yourself feeling better. And there's a doctor that I absolutely love. He just passed away a few years ago. His name was Dr. John Sarno. I actually met him about 15 years ago. And he has this diagnosis that's somewhat controversial. It's called TMS. Be open-minded when it comes to this type of diagnosis, okay? Dr. Sarno would say that people have chronic back pain, like 99% of the time, is not due to structural abnormalities, meaning that everyone has herniated disc. Everyone, you know, has stenosis. Everyone has arthritis in their spine. Why some people feel pain and others don't has to do with more your underlying subconscious emotions that you're not aware of. I know it can sound a little crazy. So if you have things that are troubling you, if you have the personality where you, he calls it the good and perfect, like you like to take care of people, you know, you want to be a good person. It's actually a compliment to say you have TMS. If you're driven, if you're a successful person, but you have this chronic back pain, he would say that the autonomic nervous system, to distract you from what's subconsciously really bothering you, is stopping the circulation of blood and oxygen to your back, and that's what's causing you the pain. I know it sounds a little crazy, but I've seen it in real life work for multiple people. It's even worked for myself. So for example, what you have to do is that when you're feeling back pain, you have to say to yourself that the back pain that I'm feeling is because I'm really upset about something that I'm not even conscious of. It could be things from childhood, accumulations from life. If you're going through a very stressful period within your life, that could be what's causing your back pain. And all you have to do to fix this is to say to yourself, the reason that my back is hurting is to distract me from what's really bothering me. So I'm also gonna put a link below this video to his book, Mind Over Back Pain. It was like the number one best-selling book for back pain like 20 years ago. But there's really a lot to this diagnosis, especially before you run and get an operation. You owe it to yourself to at least read this book. And I'm gonna give you a few other links. There are a couple of other doctors and a couple of other books that really explain this TMS diagnosis in great detail. And I really think that can help you. Now, I hope this video helped you. If you wanna learn more about just getting in shape and feeling your best, check out this playlist of videos.